After a long legal battle, terrorist supporter David Hicks will be allowed to cash in on his crimes after all. Prosecutors today agreed to drop the case against him, which had frozen the profits from his book. Ellie Southwood has been speaking with the man himself.
It takes a lot for David Hicks to speak out. Today, though, he agreed to talk after a big court win.
As I've been saying all along, my legal team, it was all a waste of time, and today's decision has proven that.
The Commonwealth DPP took Hicks to court last year, claiming any money Hicks made from the sale of his new book was the proceeds of crime. Today, though, the DPP dropped its case.
If I was what they have always claimed I would have been, then they would have had evidence to back this up, and they don't have that.
Hicks's lawyer, Stephen Glass, was notified by the DPP last night, 1 week before they were due to go to trial.
The crux of this case was that they needed, as a first step, to prove that a crime had been committed, and it would seem that they weren't able to get over that very first hurdle.
David Hicks was captured in Afghanistan in 2001 and was detained in Guantanamo Bay for 6 years. In 2007, he finally pleaded guilty to supporting terrorism. But Hicks claims he pleaded guilty under duress, believing it was his only way out.
David Hicks's case hinged on three main witnesses, his two American lawyers and a guard from Guantanamo. All three planned to fly here to give evidence about the way David Hicks was treated while in detention.
You could say I now won't have a chance to present my evidence. However, I think the decision of the DPP in itself says a lot.
In a statement, the DPP said, "I reached the view that this office was not in a position to satisfy the court that the admissions made by David Hicks in the US should be relied upon."
This is a decision for the DPP, independent of government.
He now stands to receive $10,000 in book sales. Ellie Southwood, 10 News.